Now we're going to move on to the second degree price discrimination. It is just quantity discount. So if you see buy one, get one 50% off, or if you see free gift with purchase, that's just quantity discount, and that is second degree price discrimination. Another example of the second degree price discrimination will be the quantity discount of fragrance. So I get the screenshots from Sephora, and you can see the same type of a Chanel fragrance. The price goes up from 82 to 108 to 138. Now we're ready to analyze the unit price of our Chanel fragrance. We know we have a size small, medium, large. The small is 1.2 ounce, medium 1.7, and the large 3.4 ounce. And the price of the small, medium, large are $82, $108, and $138 respectively. And therefore, the unit price of the first 1.2 ounce will be 82 divided by 1.2, and that gives you $68 per ounce. What about the next 0.5 ounce? We know that moving from small to medium bottle, we are gaining half an ounce by paying $26 more. 108 minus 82 is equal to 26. So 26 divided by 0.5 will give you $52 per ounce. So that's the unit price when we're moving from small to medium. What about the unit price of the last 1.7 ounce? So suppose we're moving from medium size to large size. Then we're gaining 1.7 ounce because 3.4 minus 1.7 is 1.7. By paying $30 more because our price goes up from 108 to 138. So what is the unit price? It will be 30 divided by 1.7, which gives us $17.64. Therefore, you can say that unit price is going down when you're buying more. We can graphically compare no price discrimination and the second degree price discrimination. So we already talked about no price discrimination, but the second degree price discrimination, you can see that if you're buying Q1, your unit price is P1. If you're buying between Q1 and Q2, your unit price is P2. If you're buying even more between Q2 and Q3, your unit price is P3. And that's exactly the situation of our Chanel fragrance pricing. Notice that our consumer surplus, the blue triangle, is already smaller than the big blue triangle with no price discrimination. Why is that our consumer surplus goes down? Well, because the firm takes away your consumer surplus and it goes to the firm's profit.